Hi, it's Dr. Z. I'll be discussing the etiology of eating and feeding disorders today. By the end of this video, you'll be able to describe the biological and psychological perspectives related to the development of these disorders. Please feel free to pause the video at any time to take notes. Similar to anxiety disorders, there are two paths a psychologist can take when determining the potential cause of eating disorders. One path focuses on the biological perspective, and the other focuses on the psychological perspective. Each perspective can be separated into more specific causes. The biological perspective on abnormal behavior focuses on the role of genetics, family history, neuroanatomy, and neurobiology. Biological research, particularly with the use of animal models, has revolutionized our understanding of several psychological disorders. The first specific biological cause involves the hypothalamus. Recall that the hypothalamus is a brain structure that regulates hunger, thirst, sexual behavior, and a wide variety of emotional behaviors. Animal studies indicate that targeted damage of certain areas of the hypothalamus result in extreme changes in eating, though it's important to note that at this time, there is no evidence of consistent abnormalities of the hypothalamus in humans. The second biological cause is related to activity-based anorexia. Animal models of anorexia nervosa attempt to understand the excessive hyperactivity seen in patients with the disorder. Experiments have shown that rodents with unlimited access to a running wheel, and who also have scheduled feeding, tend to engage in excessive use of the running wheel and decreased feeding as a result. This can lead to extreme weight loss and death from emaciation. The third biological cause addresses an addiction model of binge eating. When it comes to eating disorders with a binge eating component, there appears to be similarities to addictive disorders. Brain imaging studies reveal the role of dopamine and the orbitofrontal cortex in individuals with binge eating disorder. Recall that dopamine is a neurotransmitter that plays a role in pleasure, reinforcement, and motivation. The orbitofrontal cortex is involved in decision-making, as well as contains areas associated with taste, reward, and smell. The fourth biological cause is related to neuroendocrine and neurohormonal factors that affect feeding behavior and impulse control. Neurotransmitters serotonin and dopamine may have an influence on feeding initiation, satiety, or the feeling of fullness or satisfaction, craving, and appetite. Recall that serotonin plays a role in mood, sleep, and appetite. Brain imaging studies also suggest that abnormalities in the levels of serotonin and dopamine affect mood and pleasure, respectively. The fifth specific biological cause is related to neuroanatomy. Brain imaging studies suggest that there are structural brain abnormalities in patients with anorexia nervosa. Specifically, reduced brain mass and loss of gray matter have been found. Studies using functional MRI to determine any functional differences in the brain have found decreased brain glucose metabolism at rest, and increased serotonin activity in individuals with anorexia and bulimia nervosa. These brain abnormalities appear to be related to rigid, inflexible, and over-controlled behavior. The sixth specific biological cause is related to family and genetic studies. This specific etiology indicates that eating disorders such as anorexia nervosa, bulimia nervosa, and binge eating disorder may be inherited. Studies have indicated that not all family members share the same eating disorder. Rather, may experience a variety of eating disorders, including types of OSFED, or other specified feeding and eating disorders. Additionally, genetic studies are promising in identifying certain chromosomes associated with eating disorders. Now let's turn to the psychological perspective. The psychological perspective on abnormal behavior arises from several different approaches, such as psychoanalytic, behavioral, and cognitive. The first specific cause is related to psychodynamic theory. Recall that psychoanalytic theory focuses on early childhood experiences. Thus, this approach views the role of family dynamics and interpersonal relationships during formative years as important in the development and maintenance of eating disorders. In the film Girl Interrupted, the character of Daisy appears to have been sexually abused as a child, which may be one contributing factor to her eating disorder. The second specific cause is related to family models of eating disorder. Salvador Mnuchin studied how family dysfunction may contribute to anorexia nervosa. He identified four dysfunctional patterns of family interaction, one of which is called enmeshment. Enmeshment describes the over-involvement of all family members in the life of any one family member. The film Black Swan describes the story of a young ballerina and her over-controlling and over-involved mother. The third specific cause is related to cognitive behavioral theory. Recall that the cognitive behavioral perspective focuses on how distorted thoughts can lead to unhealthy behaviors. In the case of eating disorders, this model describes how distorted and irrational thoughts about food, body shape, weight, and even personal control may contribute to unhealthy eating and weight-related behaviors. In essence, thoughts have the power to influence how one thinks, feels, and behaves. The film Pounds is an example of an overweight man who moves to the country to lose weight, and in the process starts to think differently about food and himself. The fourth specific cause is related to sociocultural theories. In this case, the Western cultural preoccupation with thinness as the main measure of beauty may contribute to disordered eating and unhealthy behaviors. In societies where the ideal image of beauty is not tied to thinness, research has observed less incidence of eating disorders. The film 13 illustrates how a 13-year-old can be influenced by her peers and societal expectations. In summary, there are two broad perspectives on the etiology of eating disorders, and each perspective is valuable in guiding the future treatment of your client. The photos used in this video are property of the above-mentioned films. Thank you.